Greetings, Pioneers, and welcome back to the step-by-step build guide. In the last episode, I showed you how to build the simple oil factory, and today I will upgrade it by building a power plant. Requirements are the diluted packaged fuel and the heavy oil residue recipe. The power plant will operate on 300 oil and 880 water per minute, and will yield 9 gigawatts of power, and as a byproduct 120 rubber per minute, which is basically why I'm calling this an upgrade, because we are going to use the existing infrastructure to transport it off. And that's basically it. The rest of the build is dedicated only to power production. The first segment is the oil processing step. Build a refinery pit for 14 refineries, which would be the size of 18x3, and connect 10 of them to the fully overclocked normal oil node. 8 of them will operate the heavy oil residue recipe, the other 2 normal rubber. Together, they will generate 360 heavy oil residue. The remaining refineries need to be fed 160 water per minute, because they will recycle polymer resin byproduct from the first 8 refineries. The next segment of the power plant is the full production. If you follow this design, you need to widen the platform by 1 foundation, since you need more space for the packagers just behind the refineries. You will need 12 of each, or to be more precise, 3 groups of 4, to turn 720 water together with the heavy oil residue into 720 fuel. Every machine except for the first 2 water extractors and the oil pump will run on 100%, and the ratio from water packager to refinery is 1:1. At this point I'm already closing up the floor, because I will bring in the rest of the water from the ceiling later. To prepare the packagers for the rest of the water, I use the following build technique. First, I built a 2-meter foundation behind the packagers to set my cross junctions for the pipeline. Then I delete the foundations and put down some pipeline supports. Then I'm building the pipe, and then I'm ready to go to connect the water at any junction I like. Okay, let's get to the third section of the power plant. You saw the thumbnail and know what's coming. I'm going to build a fuel tower power setup. First, I'm measuring out the space with those 7x7 placeholders, and before I continue, I prepare 3 storage containers for the empty canisters, so I can let a single constructor let them fill up while I'm busy with the towers. At this point, you could also just build 3 rows of 12 generators and be done with it, but I implore you to try this method. Building small circles is the hardest part of it, and setting them up like this is incredibly rewarding. Start by filling in a normal grid, so you can place the generators 2 meters away from the inside hole. Afterwards, you can delete the grid inside and build out the foundations from the circle, so you get a nice circle in the center of the build. After you build out the walls, in this case 28 meters high, you can repeat the process by placing another grid and another row of generators. All credits for this build technique go out to Flipwork. I will link his video in the description. He's a German creator though, so I will also explain the whole thing in a more detailed way in my next video. But since I want to give him some more credit, I will link a second video of his, which is very interesting time-lapse. The main body of the factory is now complete, but there are a few more steps we have to take. Let's start with the byproducts of the oil refining. The heavy oil residue recipe puts out polymer resin as a byproduct, so we're going to build the ceiling and collect it on a merge line, so we can build a conveyor belt all around the pit and feed the refineries which are producing the residual rubber. Since the 2 machines between them produce also rubber, they can also be merged, and shipped off to the existing infrastructure where there's already a truck station waiting for it. Let me summarize what we've done so far. We built our first segment for the oil refinement and also 4 additional refineries to get rid of all the polymerism byproduct. Then we built the second segment for the fuel refinement and connected the heavy oil residue to it. After closing up the floor and building a roof, it's time to build some water extractors for the water packagers. 2 groups of 3 water extractors each, all running on 100%, will give us just the right amount of water we need. All resource inputs are connected now, and all that's left to do is the logistic for the packaged fuel itself. Most notably, the unpackaging system on each roof of the towers. By the way, if you line up conveyor holes perfectly, there will be no build limit if you build some lifts between them. Now it's finally time to turn on the power. I recommend to let the system back up before you start the process though. Your conveyor system should look like this. 3 rows of Mark III belts transporting 240 canisters each. It's gonna get pretty loud here in a second, so I leave you to enjoy the conveyor system all on your own. As you can see, the conveyor belts are feeding back into the system, so we essentially have 3 closed circuits. And last but not least, as I mentioned earlier, I wanted to bring in the water from the ceiling, so I connected it like this. There is one more thing left to do, and that is installing an awesome sink. Link it up to the rubber output to make sure the production gets never backed up. So this is how you build a packaged diluted fuel power plant. Realistically, you would build it only once, right when you get access to it, since you would use blenders on the later game stages and maybe avoid this thing altogether, since the logistics can seem very overwhelming at first. If you need some more details on how to build this, then check out my previous or my upcoming video. You can also ask me in the comments, and please don't forget to like, it actually helps a lot. So long, pioneers, thanks for watching and see you soon. Thank you.